All right, y'all. I think we're on day 29, which is crazy. I'm about to hit day 30. Didn't think I'd be posting daily when I started posting this content. I mean, that was the goal at some point. But I literally went from posting zero content to posting every single day. And then I started doing the full day of eating vlogs as well. So I went from posting nothing. Oh, let me turn this on. I went from posting nothing to posting two videos a day, which I'm pretty happy about. Now, a little serious moment. It's 8:40. We're on our way to the gym. I thought about working out at the home gym again because mentally I was kind of going through it today. And we're not going to get into the details of it because it's irrelevant. You know, we all have our own problems. But I was mentally, or I am still, extremely mentally overwhelmed with some things going on in my life. And the reason I want to bring that up is because, I'm just making sure the mic is picking up what I'm saying here, is because on social media, you don't see everything, and it leaves room for a lot of people to make assumptions. Typically, people are showing the highlight reels of their lives, right? So everything looks great, but it's never perfect. So, you know, I'm showing myself eating good food. I'm living a good life. I have a girlfriend that loves me. I mean, I got emotional the other night just thinking about all the people in my life that love me and how much I have to be grateful for. And that hasn't changed. But there are some other, I mean, there's always, you know, problems. And I guess when I get mentally overwhelmed, like I am today, in relation to diet and exercise, my brain tells me kind of to give up, like take the day off and eat whatever you want. And you know, different people would attribute that to different things, but I think it's just a physiological response. Like, you're obviously under a tremendous amount of stress. Why don't you stop worrying about the diet? Why don't you stop worrying about, you know, needing to get exercise and putting your body through all that physical stress as well? Why don't you just be lazy and just not adhere to the plan? It'll give you one less thing to think about. I feel like that's the brain's executive decision-making. It's like, pull away from this task so that you can better handle the stress of another task. But you are in total control. We are in total control. You can choose to do whatever you want. You can choose to override the programming. But that's who I am. I eat out of stress and I eat out of boredom. And I've been overriding the boredom eating successfully. I've even managed to like eat some kind of, so like last night I ate Cane's, but it was within my caloric deficit. But back in the day, if I would have eaten Cane's, even if it wouldn't have made me spill over on calories, it would have set off this cascade of just falling out of my diet. But I've been able to eat Cane's twice now within my caloric deficit. So I planned ahead so that I could eat it and then get back on my diet and not just binge and go out of control. So I'm overriding the programming in my brain. Now today was the first time, not that I don't have stress every single day, but today it just got overwhelming. This was the first time that I had to override the stress response where my body just wants me to stop. And I said, you know what? I could eat freely. I could just binge right now. We have leftover Halloween candy at the house. We have Oreos. We have Caroline's cookies that are like 700 calories a piece. And my first instinct was like, eat it. Eat. I think just as kind of like an escape to get my mind off it. But you know what? That's going to cause more problems. And I had to like step outside myself and think about it. You know, same with the working out. I was kind of like, I'll just take today off. I've been having a little elbow pain here and there. And, you know, there's different things. I'm working out every day. Maybe I deserve a day off. Who knows? But I thought about it and I was like, you know, if I eat whatever I want and I break the diet, that could cause, you know, a cascading effect of me just falling off. And it's not going to make the problems any better. It's not addressing the stressors, you know, at all. Same with the exercise. I could take a day off. That might actually be beneficial for me. But every night that I've worked out, no matter how tired I am, I feel better and I'm happy that I did so after I've done it. So once again, I could take the day off of working out, but that's not going to make the stressors go away. They're completely unrelated to the diet and the gym. The diet and the gym is a constant in my life, a constant positive right now. And I'm getting leaner and I feel better every day. And I'm maintaining my strength for the most part, and I feel great. And it's directly correlated to diet and exercise. So I just want to throw that out there because I know we're all going through shit. And don't let it get the best of you. But I'm almost already at the gym. We hadn't even discussed the workout, which you'll see it once we get in there. I'm doing shoulders. It's a shoulder only day. I'm probably going to start off with some form of overhead pressing, probably a machine. Just so I don't have to throw the dumbbells up on my shoulders. One less thing to worry about. It also provides more stabilization so you can hit the muscle more directly. I'm going to do some lateral raises, probably two different variations. They have an Arsenal machine that I'll probably use and dumbbells or cables as well. I might do some front raises and I'm going to do some rears. I'll do the rears at the end. Because unlike most people, my rear delt is the dominant part of my delt. My rear delt is quite developed, and my front delt is actually lacking, which I almost never hear people say. Almost everyone says no one's front delt is lacking because they get plenty of work in all the push movements from chest. I don't know if my chest just takes over or if I just genetically have small front delts. But that is the least impressive part of my delt, followed by my lateral head, and then the most developed being my rear delt. I could skip rear delts entirely, and I would be just fine, but for the sake of a well-rounded pump, I'm gonna hit the rear delts at the end, just to get some blood flow in them. And that is the plan. I waited about 25 minutes before I left the house, so the pre-workout is starting to kick in. I'm feeling kind of tingly. I had steak and rice and gravy about an hour ago, so I got some carbs in my system, and I'm ready to hit it. And one of the reasons I came to the gym tonight, I was going to do it at home because I have the stuff to do this whole workout at home. If you've seen the home gym, I have a nice home gym. But I needed to get out of the house. I needed to do this car talk and express those thoughts to y'all, and I just need to be in a different environment where I can kind of detach from the world, you know? So, that's it. Let's get into the gym. All right, y'all, so this is gonna be my first time using this machine. I'm no longer recording my warm-up sets. I'm only recording my working sets. Just to shorten the video, because they've been kind of long. I would love to use these neutral grips, but they're so far back and at a weird angle. I wish they were about right here, and that would be ideal. But I tried to use them just now. They're just not comfortable. So I'm going to use these. And I'm doing this because less stabilization, so it's going to target the front delt more. It also is going to hit the lateral delts as well. And then also, I don't have to throw the dumbbells up onto my shoulders, so less chance of getting injured. So I did record a warm-up set. And I'm just going to leave this in the video. All right. Now this should be the first working set. Added a 25 to each side. So we got two plates and a 25 on each side. I was certain two plates would be a working set because I did two plates on the incline bench arsenal. Actually, no, it's a prime machine. Maybe it's a difference in equipment. But didn't think I'd be doing two plates and a 25 on here, but here we are. All right. That was a working set. I also made my first acquaintance here at the gym. Right when I walked in, there was this guy and he started asking me about camera stuff because he had seen me filming. So I apologized to him because I was like kind of talking his head off, but I'm a nerd with this kind of stuff. So it's like, but when you don't know anything about it and then someone starts going off, it's like you're speaking a different language. So I was like, sorry, man. But he was really cool. He was cool as fuck, actually. He was wearing a big sweater, so I don't know what he looks like. But it seemed like he was probably pretty jacked. I think I'm going to do three working sets here. Just because I really like the way this machine feels. Yeah, that's pretty much the only reason. Because I really like the way it feels. And my front delts need the work, you know. All right. One thing I really love about these machines is, I don't know if you can see this right here. I mean, you can. I always say that. I don't know if you can see it, but I'm looking and I can see that you can see it. But this is adjustable. So you're not having to start with your arms all the way down in a compromised position or too high up. You can adjust it exactly where you want. And I see some people using those like barbell clips to get started because machines are too far back or down or whatever. You don't have to do that with these. They're adjustable. Ingenious design. I'm realizing now that I flexed my pecs that they're pretty sore from that chest day, which was not yesterday, but the day before that. I've never stopped getting sore from training. I feel like so many people have after they've trained a while, they stop getting sore, but not me. I always get sore. Now, one thing I did is I'm kind of trying to lift a little less with my ego. So I took the 25 off and I put a 10 and a 5. So I went down 10 pounds on each arm because I got 8 reps last time, but I don't want any less than that for this last set. So that's why I went down. I'm glad I went down. All right, so we're going to go to, I think I'm going to do this arsenal lateral machine, but I'm going to do it one arm at a time. And then I'm going to do some front raises with a cable, then lateral cables, then rear delts. I remember the whole point of the mic'd up gym video is to kind of give you the insight into what the lifter's thinking. So I've already changed my mind on what I'm gonna do. I had 5 movements in my head. But the first thing that I did, the overhead, hit front and laterals. Then this I'm doing at a 45, so this is gonna hit front and laterals as well. So I may stop here and go into rears. I may only do 3 movements. Unless I'm feeling spicy, then I'll do 4 movements. I'll do one more for the lateral before I get into rears. But 5 movements was gonna be way too much, unless I decrease the working sets. But I kind of feel like just staying on one thing. And this is going to be way too light. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I just did 12 with that, with 120. I thought my working weight was gonna be like 50 or 60. It was 120. And it's actually more than that because I don't want to get 12 reps. I just did this side to match the other side. We're gonna go up and wait. All right, so I'll probably do two more sets on here. I do consider that first set a working set. It might have not looked that intense, but 12 reps was like the last full rep I could get. I didn't do any partials or anything, but it was within two or three reps of failure for sure. So we're gonna count that as a working set. This will be the second working set. I went up to 140 from 120. That was good. That was a good weight. And I've had some mindset shifts with the content creation. So at first I was attempting to make these videos better, but I noticed a lot of people were comparing me negatively to Sam Sulik. So I'm actually putting less time into these videos so they're like easier to edit, like basically take no editing at all. I'm just using one camera and I'm putting more time into my full day of eating videos because I actually enjoy making the vlog style videos a lot more than I enjoy these. But I'm not gonna stop posting these because I still want people to have the option to see the workout and get in my mindset if they so choose. It's also, like I said, very easy to produce. So there's no point in me stopping making these. When I broke out both cameras, the editing was taking like four times as long and it just wasn't sustainable. So I'm doing whatever I can so that I can post daily content, two videos a day. And I really wanna step it up at some point and start producing other stuff as well. But I love daily content. That's like my main focus right now. All right, last working set. Yeah, that feels good. I'm also glad this gym isn't ever busy because at the time I come, it's got to be busy sometimes because they're in business. But I had that Caniac combo last night and I'm ripping ass, like disrespectfully. It's like, it's heavy in the air and it lingers and it smells like I shit in my pants. It's really bad. But there's no one around, so I don't feel like I'm not offending anyone, I don't think. Otherwise, I'd be really embarrassed because it's pretty intense. All right, and in the moment as I'm doing these, I decided if they have one of those like little lateral raise machines, you know, where you put your arms on the pads, if they have something like that here, I'm gonna do like three sets of that and then I'll do rear delts because I just don't feel like I've done enough. keeping in theme what we were talking about last set. Yeah, the biceps and triceps, you don't have to separate them because the biceps aren't fatiguing the triceps. Like, sure, the work is fatiguing the overall system, but it's not directly inhibiting the other muscle. Whereas like shoulders and chest, you're working your shoulders with your chest. So if you do a chest movement, you fatigue your shoulders. And if you do a shoulder movement, you're decreasing the output you can put out on chest. Same with like back and biceps, chest and triceps. You're always gonna be kind of prioritizing one over the other. So it's just nice to separate them. Back on its own day, chest on its own day, shoulders on its own day, arms on their own day. And then of course legs, because I know y'all aren't skipping legs. All right. And if y'all notice, I'm not holding on to these handles because it doesn't feel good. I'm putting my arms where they feel natural, and I'm just doing lateral raises. All right, one more working set and then rear delts. If you're doing this machine, never, ever sit like this. It's just not optimal. Always get in here like this, nice and up on the bench. Lean forward a little bit, just like that. I thought that'd be a working weight, but it wasn't. I mean, that was almost a working set. We're gonna count it because I don't really need to do rear delts. But we're gonna go up and wait, and we're gonna do a couple more. Two more here, and then we're out of here. Pretty quick workout. I think it took about 45 minutes in. Yeah, the rear delts, they just feel good. Once everything's pumped. All right, y'all, last working set. And I lied, I said one more working set and we'd be out of here, but it's really one more working set and a pump check. And then we'll be out of here. Feels good to be done. All right, so kind of like doing the pump check right here by the squat rack because I can hang my hat on this like so. All right, let's see what's going on. So, if I could change one thing about this gym, I'd make like a little posing area. And I'm not even a bodybuilder. What am I seeing in front of my arm? Oh, it's the graphic on the screen of the camera. But yeah, I'm not even a bodybuilder. I'm just like an average Joe that wants to look good. And I desire better lighting. I'm spoiled to the lighting at Red's. But yeah, when the delts are pumped, I like the way they look. When they're not pumped, they're too small. But see, that rear delt is just, I don't know if y'all see what I see. But what I see is the real thing. What y'all see, if y'all don't see what I see, then y'all are missing out. That rear delt just like goes past the tricep, completely separated from the trap. That's crazy. And we see the veins coming in. I mean, once again, I don't know if y'all can see that. The lights are so bright in here that it really just, this is not your influencer gym. Maybe if I took a picture in here and brought it into Photoshop or something, but with the raw lighting, it is not flattering, I'll tell you that. But the fact that I still look decent in this light speaks volumes. It speaks volumes. And I'm not even like a cocky, I'm not very self-confident, to be honest. I mean, I like the person I am, but as far as my body's concerned, I'd say it's pretty mid. But almost everyone that's like seen me in a video and then sees me in person, they're like, you're way bigger than I thought you were. So keep that in mind. You know, I mean, don't compare me to Sam. I am tiny compared to him, but other than that, I'm pretty, I got a little bit of muscle on me, you know? Anyway, as we get leaner, it'll start to look better. But that's it for the pump check. I don't really know what to do. I mean, I can hit like a side chest, but all we hit is delts. So the chest isn't pumped or anything. So that's it for tonight. I'm gonna go home. I got some lasagna and I'm gonna make a patty melt. It's gonna be freaking awesome. But I'm gonna see you in the truck. So let's go to the truck. All right, y'all, so just like that, another day down. And like I said, first off, I know I just had a Caniac combo last night, but there's a Canes, there's a Checkers, and then right after that, there's a Canes. It's right there. I can literally see the sign. And the smell is wafting, just like the smell of my gas in the gym. But this smell is good. There's also an ambulance pulling into this apartment complex, so hopefully everybody's all right. But, the smell of that Canes, pretty enticing. Pretty enticing. But tonight on the menu, I have a short rib lasagna, and I'm going to make a patty melt. So I have some 90-10 bison. I have some reduced fat Swiss cheese. And I'm gonna grill some onions. I'm gonna make a patty melt, a double patty, 2 5-ounce patties. And I'm gonna eat a third of this lasagna. It comes from Costco. But I had it already. Last time I ate the whole freaking lasagna, it was like 2,000 calories. I did that on the cut. I don't know if I was filming these full day of eatings at that point. Oh, let me buckle up for my safety.
Anyway, I don't think I was doing my full day of eatings at that point, but I ate the whole freaking lasagna. And it was very filling. But I don't have that amount of calories available to me. And I got this keto bread. It's 35 calories a slice. It's like sandwich bread, you know, like white bread. So we're gonna see how that goes. Typically I try to be gluten-free just because I do notice, like, once again, I don't have any, I'm not celiac, or I don't even think I'm really, like, known gluten intolerant. But, like, I had the Cane's last night, the chicken's fried in gluten, I mean, like, flour, and the bread, and I am so freaking gassy, so, and I'm bloated. So I know that the bread doesn't agree with me. I know flour doesn't agree with me, but it's just so delicious. So, and if you cut flour out of your diet, if you go gluten-free, you are really decreasing the amount of fun you can have with food. Like, a lot. I mean, flour tortillas, anything, like graham cracker crumbs on a cheesecake. Everything has gluten in it. Any fried food. It's all gluten. Breads. Breads alone. Being gluten-free and not being able to have breads. Like, gluten-free bread freaking sucks. I had researched best gluten-free bread, and I ordered some online, and I ate, like, one slice of one of the loaves, and the other two are in the freezer. It did not do the trick. Not enjoyable. So, if you go gluten-free, man, what a heavy burden to bear. But, like I said, I typically feel less bloated, so I try to avoid it. So I'm like, you know, I'm like 80% gluten avoiding. But I'm definitely not gluten free. And I'm definitely going to enjoy these patty melts. But yeah, let me see what that meal's going to add up to. As far as the workout goes, like I said, it's great to be able to focus on just one muscle group. It takes less time. It's less taxing. You're not, you know, sacrificing one thing for the other, all beneficial. The only thing I find is that the pump isn't as good, because I like for multiple things to be pumped. Like, I imagine the best pump, like one of the best pumps I used to get was when I did chest and back on the same day, because the chest is pumping the shoulders, the chest and the triceps, and the back is pumping the back and the biceps and the traps. So your whole upper body's pumped, and you got to use your grip, so your forearms are pumped, like everything is pumped. That's probably chest and back is the best. If you're a pump chaser, that is the best day. That's the best kind of workout, chest and back. And I've seen Sulik say that he doesn't like chest and back because he does all his chest and then he does all his back, and by the time he finishes his back, his chest isn't pumped anymore. Pretty simple solution. Do one chest movement, then one back movement, then one chest, alternate. They're both pumped. At the end of the workout, they'll both be pumped. And you're not sacrificing all your energy for one and then putting the other on the back burner. All right. This dinner is going to have 1,365 calories, which means I could have eaten a box combo. But I wouldn't waste my time with a box combo. I need a Caniac. Oh, wait, hold on. So 3,015 calories for the day. Let's see. 243 grams of protein, 200 carbs, and 143 grams of fat. So that's pretty high fat, actually. But calories in, calories out. It doesn't matter. Protein's the only relevant macronutrient and calories. Okay. So this dinner has 1,365 calories and 124 grams of protein. Can you believe it? 124 grams of protein. That's nuts. And don't be one of those people that thinks your body can only absorb like 30 to 50 grams of protein at a time. That is not true at all. It'll absorb all the protein. Some people think you pee out the... Some people think if you eat too much protein, you pee it out. No. No. You absorb it. It takes you a longer time to digest it. Over a longer period of time, you are absorbing the protein. Is it more optimal to split your protein into like five divided meals? Supposedly so. Supposedly you have five opportunities for protein synthesis throughout the day. Not six, not four, five. So the most optimal thing you can do, in theory, from what I've been told, from what the science says, is 5 meals. But I'm doing 3 meals a day. And usually a couple of my meals have like around 100 grams of protein in it. So that's just the way it is. And I mean, I'm not small, you know? I'm not small. I have some muscle mass on me, so it must be working. If I am peeing out the protein, the excess protein, then I guess I don't need it, because I am making some progress. But I was kind of, you know, I was in a bad place mentally before I started that workout. I expressed that to y'all. I came work out anyway. I didn't cheat on my diet, and I feel a little bit better. It didn't solve the problem, you know, as a temporary release, temporary escape, distraction, you might say. Didn't solve the problem. I still have to deal with that. And it's not a problem at home. I kind of started thinking maybe one might infer that, because I was like, I got to get away from the house. No, home is rock solid. Girlfriend, dogs, house, beautiful. It's actually like what's keeping me going. It's external from the house, okay? But we're going to get it solved. I kind of didn't have my priorities in the right place for a little while. So we're gonna start taking care of business. Because what happens is, I'll just go over this real quick before I walk inside. For anyone like that's dealing with the same thing, what happens is, like, sometimes you have a problem, right? And it's difficult to deal with. So you put it off. And you kind of, you find distractions and focus on other things that are more positive. But if the problem doesn't get solved, it's actually just going to get worse and worse and worse. You know, it's still there. It never goes away. And it's just going to be building. And even if you manage to, like, put it out of your mind for a while, at some point, it's going to come back to bite you in the ass. And that's essentially what's happening to me right now. So, it's nothing we can't solve. It's basically just takes time and money, you know, without going into what the problem is. It's just something that I got to deal with that I've been needing to deal with for a while. So everything's going to fall into place. Everything works out. But that's where we're at. So I'm home. Going to go enjoy the time with my little family. Eat a good meal. And I will see y'all for dinner. I won't see y'all for dinner, because this isn't the full day of eating. I'll see y'all in the next video.